In today's video, we are going to learn about the structure and function of heart. According to the topic, you are able to guess the main function of our heart, that is pumping of the blood. Heart is an organ which is present in the right side of the thoracic cavity of our body. Thoracic cavity means the cavity which is present at the chest side. The chest cavity is known as thoracic cavity. So the heart, which is the pumping organ of our body, which pumps blood to all the parts of the body, is present on the right side of the thoracic cavity. That means right side of the chest. It is present between the two lobes of the lungs and is protected by ribs, sternum, and backbone. So from all four sides it is protected. Now we will go with its structure. Our heart is a mammalian heart which consists of four chambers, a pair of atrium and a pair of ventricles. Now we will first of all start with the first atrium. It is known as left atrium. Okay, I'm teaching you this left atrium. Always, whenever you are drawing or whenever you are learning or reading the structure of heart, okay, you have to turn the book or you have to turn the diagram towards your chest. That means this side is your right side in your body, but in diagram it will become left side. So the left side, so the side, the right side of your heart is actually left side in the diagram. So you have to study like this. Fine. So this is left side, but in your side this is right side, but actually we are going through the left side. So the left side of the heart receives the oxygenated blood. The left side of the heart receives the oxygenated blood from the heart, from the lungs. Theek hai? Left side of the heart, which is left atrium. This is the left atrium. So the left atrium receives the blood from the lungs, which is oxygenated blood. Okay. So this is the first chamber. The second chamber is left ventricle. Left atrium, left ventricle. Okay, left ventricle will receive the blood from the left atrium. Left ventricle will receive the blood from the left atrium, which will be also oxygenated blood. Fine. Now we will, what will happen after some time, that the left ventricle will pump the blood or push the blood to the aorta, and from aorta the blood will be distributed to all over the body part. Fine. Okay, so whenever you are studying left side of the heart, okay, it will be right side, it will be on the right hand side. Fine. So always remember this. Don't ever mark the right hand side chamber as right atrium and right ventricle. It will be wrong. The right hand side chamber will be left. Okay, so this is left atrium, this is left ventricle. Fine. There is a bicuspid valve present between left atrium and left ventricle. Bicuspid means a two cup shape valve is present here. Fine. Now the oxygenated blood goes to aorta from left ventricle and it goes and gets distributed all through the body. Now what happens? The blood which has gone to all the cells through aorta will be collected, okay, will be collected in blood capillaries, and from blood capillaries it will go to the vena cava. Okay, vena cava. Vena cava is in a pair, superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Inferior vena cava will collect the blood from below the shoulder, and the superior vena cava will collect the blood from above the shoulder. So superior vena cava will collect the blood from head and neck, which is deoxygenated, and it will come into the right atrium. And inferior vena cava, or you can say posterior vena cava, will collect the blood from below the shoulder, and it will be, and this blood is also deoxygenated, and it will come to the right atrium. So the right side always collects deoxygenated blood, while left side collects oxygenated blood. This was the question last time, and 90% boys made it wrong. Okay, they said they thought that right side is always right and oxygenated blood is always right. So they marked oxygenated blood right side, which was wrong. Actually, deoxygenated blood comes to the right atrium. Now all the deoxygenated blood which has been collected from the superior vena cava and the posterior vena cava is now in the right atrium. Now it will go to the right ventricle. Okay, so here is also a valve present, that is tricuspid valve, which is a 3-cup shape valve. Okay, so all the blood will come here, and again there will be a push, and this will push the deoxygenated blood towards the lungs for getting it oxygenated. Fine. Okay, so this was the rough knowledge about the heart structure and its function. Now we will go broadly with the function and structure of the heart. But get one thing noted, you have to draw the same diagram, you have to practice the same diagram. There will be no change, there should be no change, no any alternative option is with you. You have to practice only this diagram only. Okay, you cannot draw any other diagram. Practice it. Just now it is looking hard, but later on if you will practice it, you will get the knowledge how to draw it without seeing also. So it may happen that the diagram will come. Okay, so I am going with the explanation. See, lungs, which is also known as pulmonary, okay, from where the blood gets oxygenated. Now that oxygenated blood comes to the right atrium. Okay, that oxygenated blood comes to the right atrium through a duct which is known as pulmonary vein. Okay, pulmonary vein. What I am saying, oxygenated blood is coming from lungs to heart by pulmonary vein. Now this makes a confusion. Till now we have known that veins only contain deoxygenated blood, but here I am saying that it is that here the pulmonary vein is transporting oxygenated blood. Now how is this happening? Why vein is transporting oxygenated blood? Till now we have known that vein only transport deoxygenated blood. Actually that definition was wrong, and for primary classes that definition was taught to us. The real definition of artery and vein is the duct which brings the blood towards the heart. Okay, the duct which brings the blood towards the heart is known as vein. There is no discussion about oxygenated or deoxygenated blood. You have to only remember the vein which brings the blood towards the heart, the duct which brings the blood towards the heart is known as vein. You don't have to say about the nature of blood, only the direction of the blood will decide that it is artery or vein. So if the blood is coming from a duct towards the heart, it is obviously vein. So here I am naming it pulmonary vein. So the lungs is giving oxygenated blood to the heart, and as a duct is coming towards the heart, so this is pulmonary vein. And why pulmonary? Pulmonary means lungs. Okay, so lungs se jo vein aa raha hai, that is pulmonary vein. So pulmonary vein se yahan par aaya oxygenated blood. Now the oxygenated blood is when the oxygenated blood is coming, at that time here that bicuspid valve is closed. So here first of all the blood gets stored. When the whole right atrium gets filled with the blood, at that time this bicuspid valve opens, and this chamber contracts. Okay, it contracts. It contracts, and when it contracts, by the bicuspid valve opens, the total blood comes to the right ventricle, and after that it relaxes, the right atrium relaxes and the bicuspid valve get closed. Okay, at the same time bicuspid valve get closed. So it, when it go to get closed, the whole blood comes to left ventricle. Okay, left ventricle. Now what happens, this left ventricle pumps the blood, and when it pumps the blood, what happens, that the whole blood goes to the aorta, and from aorta it goes to the whole all over the body. Now here the two structural thing you have to remember, that the what is the function of valve here. Actually valve is here for stopping the backflow of the blood. If the valve was not present here, and when this right ventricle contracted, the blood may have gone back to the left atrium, but to stop it there is a valve. Next is, the muscles of the left ventricle is very much thick. Why? Because it has to pump the blood with very force, with a very great, very big force, because it has to pump the blood all over the body. Okay, so next video we will go with the right side of our heart.